Hey, if you're watching this video, that means you're looking to create an e-commerce website for your online business. And on this channel, we share various ways to create apparel brands and show you how to sell them online. In this video, I want to introduce you to an e-commerce platform that is helping entrepreneurs get their business online and is truly allowing you to grow your brand internationally. And this platform is called BigCommerce, and they are generous enough to sponsor this video, but more about them in a moment. Right now, I want to discuss the key tips you need in order to properly start your online business. And the very first one that we want to start about is about knowing exactly what it is you're going to sell and creating the correct messaging and branding around that. After working with hundreds of entrepreneurs over the years throughout this channel, the most common issue we encounter is unclear messaging and branding. Now, a name is a good place for you to start, but I want you to go a little bit further into it and really tell the story to help a complete stranger quickly and effectively understand what it is that you're all about and why you offer the products that you offer. During this stage, this planning stage, it's also recommended that you guys create a business plan for how you will make money and who the ideal customer is. Now, we have free resources and links to everything that we mentioned in this video, which will be linked right in the description down below, as well as in the comments. From there, you want to jump into the designing a logo and the aesthetic that will resonate with that messaging. Now, if your brand is all about sustainability, then don't use bright neon colors, as it's not the way to go. Aesthetically, a sustainable brand is more earth tones. Logos are a little bit more thoughtfully crafted and not as bold as a corporate brand. During this stage, make sure you use online pin boards and slides to organize this information, which will help designers and your team expand on this direction. Because the reality is, guys, you're not going to be able to do everything yourself. So make sure you do the groundwork in order for other people to help you where they have strengths and skill sets. Now, once you have your name, logo, and your brand direction started, this means that you are 99% better off than entrepreneurs who are going into business for the very first time. Now, with this information, you are now ready to start creating your product lines. Use the brand direction you created to help present your brand to manufacturers and the people that you want to work with in order to get your brand off the ground. Now, you see, by putting in this groundwork, vendors will see that you aren't just going to be wasting their time asking a bunch of random questions. This increases your chances of securing quality partnerships with manufacturers and vendors of your product line. And this also opens the doors to getting free to low-cost samples of your new designs and improving the overall manufacturing experience. I can't stress this part enough, guys, as it's a common mistake most new brands make when reaching out to people they want to work with. They literally show up and say, "Hey, I have this idea for this product, can you help me?" But by putting in the groundwork, you know exactly what it is that you want from a production partner, which in turn helps them communicate what they can provide. And if you guys are okay with what they can provide and what you want, then you know it's going to be a good fit. But if they have no idea what you want and you have no idea what you're really looking for, that's when things get a little tricky and you're gonna have some very, very easy mistakes that you could have prevented if you just followed the tips that we just mentioned. A common question that overseas suppliers will then ask you once you have your design ready to ship out is if you have a shipping account so they could deliver your goods. That's why it's important that you guys establish the business the right way. This means to legitimize it. And in order to legitimize your business, you have to register it at the state and local level. Now there's two, there's your state and then your city or county. We have a video expanding on this process, which we'll link in the descriptions up above, as well as in the descriptions down below. There's a little note card that'll pop up and it'll take you to a playlist there. In short, you will have to decide what business structure you want to choose. There are various options, starting with a sole proprietor, which essentially means you're the sole owner and liable for the business, a partnership, which means you're legally partnering with someone else, a corporation or an LLC, which is a hybrid of a partnership and a corporation. Now, LLCs are a preferred entity as they help protect your assets while keeping the paperwork and legal fees lower in most states that you live in. Now, this is not legal advice, and we highly encourage that you guys speak to an attorney and certified CPA for your situation. With the registration of your business, you are now able to apply for an EIN number through the IRS website, and with that number, you can complete the registration with the sales tax department in your state. Now, the Department of Taxation will give you a number called a sales tax ID number, and with that number and business information, you can register your business to ship internationally with any major carrier, and you'll also be able to buy wholesale for major brands and businesses in the US. After receiving and approving your samples, you are now one step closer to starting your online e-commerce business. And at this point, you're probably wondering what e-commerce platform you should use. There's a lot of options out there, and it's hard to choose which one fits best. Some platforms are designed for creatives that are selling a service and some product lines. Others are designed to showcase portfolios with a little side of e-commerce. And others are great beginner-friendly e-commerce options. But for those that have a strong vision for an international e-commerce business, BigCommerce is a solution. Unlike other e-commerce platforms that provide you with tools to sell online, BigCommerce is one of the only platforms that will help you sell almost anything online. Literally anything, as long as it's legal in your country. Now, you would think that every platform that allowed you to sell and do business online would allow you to do the same thing, but they don't. Unfortunately, other platforms have very strict terms of service that constantly change. So if you're selling something that is borderline in the gray area but is legal to sell, and if that platform finds out about it, they can immediately shut down your store, causing you to lose your business overnight. I can only imagine the frustration that store owners feel when this happens, and if you're a business that relies heavily on e-commerce sales, this is not what you want happening to you. The best part about BigCommerce is that it comes with a variety of tools right out of the box, so it saves you time and also helps your website perform better, as it's not dragged down by a bunch of apps you have to install to create the features that BigCommerce has. They also allow you to connect with any card processor with no added fees. Now, other platforms allow you to connect third-party processors, but they also charge a fee on top of that. But BigCommerce allows you to connect with any payment option. So this is a great option for brands that are going to be selling globally and need to connect to third-party processors in different countries. In a few seconds, I will show you guys how to get set up with BigCommerce. But before we do that, I want to mention that we'll be showing you guys some tools and tricks to help start your marketing within this video walkthrough. So get your pen and paper out to take some notes and be on the lookout for part two of this video, where we share how to scale your e-commerce brand. In this future collaboration, we work with the CEO of Solo Stove, which is a high-growth outdoor company that went from 5 employees to 125 employees within 3 years. So make sure you guys subscribe to this channel right now if you haven't already, and turn on those post notification bells to be alerted of its video release. In that video, John Maris shares insight into how they scale their e-commerce brand successfully and profitably. I'm pumped to share that insight with you guys, and I'm ready to show you how you can get started with this BigCommerce tutorial, so let's jump right into it. To start with BigCommerce, simply create an account through the link provided down below. There's a 15-day free trial with no credit card required. Once you create your account, you'll see this dashboard. If you click on over here, you'll see your online store section. You'll see that there's already a storefront created with products inside. Now, in a moment, we're going to show you guys how to remove these and fully customize your website. Right now, I want to take you into some of these tabs on the left to help you understand how they all come together to create your e-commerce store. The first tab is the Orders tab, which allows you to view pending orders, new orders, or search for past orders from customers on your store. Under the Products tab is where you'll be adding your products. Right now, it's preloaded with all those sample products, so before we upload ours, we're just going to quickly delete all of these. Under the Customer tab, you can add customers manually or in bulk through the import feature. Now, this is where you want to go if you're changing from a different platform to BigCommerce. And then you have the Marketing tab. Now, under this tab, you have the option to add banners to your store that will populate to the store's header or footer. Now, you can also run promotions here. There's abandoned cart notifications and even create coupon codes. Now that we have that out of the way, let's go to the part where you get to customize your online store. Now, head on over to the theme marketplace to get started. You can filter through these themes under the free or paid, and also select the industry that you're into to find the designs that go with your brand's aesthetic. As you filter through some of the theme options available, you'll see that some come in different prices, from $3.99 to $300 and up. Each theme is unique here in the way that it organizes information, such as how headers are going to appear, icons, sliding bars, navigation. A lot of the features of the website can be previewed here before you buy or install it on your store. You can also do a mobile preview of those themes to ensure that it's going to work with your brand and product line. For the sake of this tutorial, we're going to go with the Fortune contrast. After uploading products to our store, we're going to start to customize this and truly make it ours. Now, as you view your storefront here, in order to import the products that you guys have uploaded, you're going to want to go into Theme Styles under the Menu option. Under this option, you have the opportunity to pull in products as well as customize colors of the theme that you want to choose. So most of the visual aesthetics for your store is going to be customizable under this menu option. Under the homepage settings, it will help you import the product lines that you have according to the theme design that you purchased. This theme came with a product option. It allows you to keep customers on the same product line. If they don't like it, they can click out and then start to shop for other product lines that you may have. Under the homepage setting, it will help you import the product lines that you have according to the theme design that you purchased. Now, a great feature about BigCommerce is that it allows you to drag and drop elements directly onto the store without coding experience. Now, for example, if you want to have a hero banner to break up some product lines, you can simply do that by adding the hero banner option into the theme store. And from there, you can upload the image and provide a call to action. You can customize the details of this call to action, from the size, to the colors, to the fonts and the buttons, and where it will take the customers after they click. By clicking on the Preview tab, you can see how this shows up on desktop and mobile view. You can continue to customize your store any way that you envision. So for us, we'd like to design an image underneath the main banner. We are able to enhance or reduce opacity as well as align the image as we see fit through this option. Now you may notice that there's a global widget here. Now what this means is that it appears throughout the entire site. Now this is a great option to announce sales or any special promotions or just for the branding of the collection that you've been working hard on. Now this is how you customize your storefront. Now I want to jump into the uploading and branding of the store. Under the storefront, you're going to find the logo option. You'll upload the logo from your computer and you refresh it to find it at the top of your page or wherever that theme puts your logo for the branding. If you want to update your call to action on your home banner, it's going to depend on the theme that you have. Now for this theme, the call to action goes underneath the image. So as I was stating earlier, guys, depending on the theme that you choose is going to depend on where some of these aesthetics go. This theme also has social media icons on the footer. And to edit the social media links, you enter the link without the HTTPS and hit save one time. You can also reorganize these links that you create by simply dragging them to the top. Now let's go to the web pages section. You'll find that there's web pages that already came with this theme. So to add a page such as an About Us, simply create a page like this and fill in the information and you should be good to go. Now you can also upload the photo, whatever photo you want from your team or to show About Us. I highly recommend that you resize images before importing them here so they show up right on the website. Now let's clean up the product area of your store as it came preloaded with different categories. Now to do this, you'll notice that you have all the different categories still existing on the homepage tab. Now to clean that up over here, select products, from there go to product categories and you can get rid of the existing ones. And now you can also create new categories in this area. Now categories should be treated like, you can call it something like t-shirts, hats, shoes, sneakers, but you can also select new categories under collections. So you can categorize a new collection, like for our example, the foundation kit. That's gonna be a category of its own. I also recommend that you preview the layout design on the mobile version to make sure everything is working properly. Now, if you wanna go back to the storefront, you can select Image Manager to find all the images that you uploaded to your website, such as banners, anything on your About Us page. And you can also navigate over to the blog site where you can create and start your official blogging of your site. It's a pretty cool feature that it allows you to upload your thumbnail as well as tags. Once you finalize your branding and some of your settings, you can preview the store and see that ours is coming along pretty nicely. I like how it's starting to look on the mobile version as well as the product categories, how these are all organized now. It's all formatting pretty nicely, and as a note, adding banners throughout your store can really bring it to life. And now it brings us into the final part of the store, which is the marketing and launch of the website. Now under the marketing tab, you'll find an option for banners. And what this means is that you can update and upload a banner specifically for collections, for a homepage, or anywhere else that you guys might need this. If you want to use an image you've already uploaded, you can select it from the dropdown that appears right here. You can also rename that file on your computer before uploading in case you change the dimensions or you edited something about it. Once you hit saves, you'll see that it loads up in a specific category that you created for that product. The example of our store here, it's under the foundation collection, and we can see how that previews here. As you can see, ours is at the bottom, and the image is kind of big, but we can essentially edit this to make it come up nicer, and we could also change the position either to the top or the bottom. BigCommerce allows you to truly brand and market collections across multiple pages pretty simply, which I think is a really cool feature, as historically, if you wanted to do anything like this, you'd have to either pay someone to code or install another application that slows down your site. Another great feature of BigCommerce is a promotions option, which allows people to qualify for discounts based on how they shop or any of the campaign that you're creating, as well as any banners that you guys might want to include to help upsell them at checkout. This comes into play with things like creating free shipping offers over a certain dollar amount. Now, BigCommerce also has an ecosystem for apps such as Klaviyo, which allow you to install it directly into BigCommerce. That way you can start to immediately begin your marketing campaign. You can manage everything within BigCommerce so it doesn't take you outside of the platform. Now, this is a great tool to help you grow your email marketing and retarget customers with ease. All of your apps that you install will be located in this area, and there's a lot of apps to choose from that'll continue to help you grow your business. Now that that site is ready, the last thing you want to do is set up your custom domain name. Now to activate this feature, you need to select a plan. Again, they have a 15-day free trial, so it doesn't charge you until the trial period ends. And there are links that we're going to link right down below to help you get started. As you look at the different tiers and options that BigCommerce has available to you, you'll notice down here that they have a cap on how much you can sell before they upgrade your plan. Now, this is because they're not charging customers any transaction fees. It's solely based on the plan that you select. Other platforms charge you a monthly fee plus transaction fees on top of everything that you sell. And if you're plugging into third-party platforms, this is really where you could spend a lot more money than what this monthly fee is. BigCommerce allows you to plug into any third party with no additional fees, and because of that, they have different plans to help you get started and grow. Once you purchase a plan, you're able to connect your domain name to BigCommerce. You'll be able to buy the domain name or connect an existing one. The easiest route is to just buy the domain at BigCommerce, and they'll give you options on what is available. Once you register the domain name, you are now good to start doing business with your custom URL. If you'd like to connect an exterior domain name, go to the settings options here and update the name servers. There's a video on our channel that will help you do this, and I'll also link it in the help section down below. Now that you have your custom domain names, you can also configure new user accounts here to help people get access to the store. You can also select the permission levels of what they'll be able to do when they log in. And the final thing to do is launch your store. You can select that under store setup, and your site is now live. Man, as you guys can see, BigCommerce has such a wide variety of tools. And to be completely honest with you guys, when I first started using the platform, I had a lot of learning curves I had to do. So I hope that this video tutorial helps to really alleviate some of those pain points. And if you guys are looking into starting with BigCommerce, make sure you guys use the links in the description down below. They are affiliate links, which helps us continue to produce content such as this. And make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel and you turn on those post notifications as we roll out part two of this video, which I'm personally excited to do because we're gonna get to talk to the CEO of Solo Stove, which is a super high growth business right now that's killing it in the outdoor space. And the CEO of that company is gonna be sharing his tips and advice to help entrepreneurs in our community, such as yourself, take their business to the next level. So thank you guys all for watching to this point. For those of you guys that are here, I realize that you're ready to start taking action on things. So I highly encourage that you guys join our communities, which are located in the descriptions down below. Through that, you guys can interact and connect. And you guys can also download your free PDF and resources that are available to help you continue building your brand and business from the ground up. When we started this channel, our mission was to do exactly that, to bring clarity to business and help you guys build a brand that impacts the world. So once again, we appreciate BigCommerce for sponsoring this video and giving us an opportunity to help share this information to continue working with entrepreneurs on a global basis. So I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video.